The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Juan McCartney is sponsored by Pamela Bank, Burger King, Seafowl, Ron's Electric Motors, Fidelity Bank Bahamas, Wendy's, J.S. Johnson, PTC, the Pan American Health Organization, Anyway Insurance Agents and Brokers, Kelly's Home Center, the Insurance Commission of the Bahamas, and the Digital Transformation.
Good afternoon, Bahamas, and welcome to the Revolution here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My name is Juan McCartney. So good to have you with us. All right. At the top of the second hour, we'll be speaking with Alive about some things that are going on there. But what we want to get into now is the information that we're receiving about the National Food Distribution Task Force. As you would have probably remembered, the last budget speech was about the state of our finances, but also a lot of it focused on the Food Distribution Task Force and what the Prime Minister characterized, or outrightly said, actually, was a lack of information on where the money actually went. And we're talking $53+ million. And so he made a lot of serious accusations in Parliament about the Food Distribution Task Force and the handling of it. And you may remember that I spoke to it on the show, and I said that it's just not good enough for the Minister of Finance, who represents the Ministry of Finance, to go to Parliament and say, we don't know what happened to $53 million without the next sentence being, therefore, we call the police. Therefore, we send demand letters from our attorneys. Therefore, we call the attorney general. You understand what I'm saying? There's no circumstance I can imagine that you're saying you're trying to get information about $50+ million from one program, and nobody's willing to speak to you about it. You can't figure it out, and you come to Parliament during the mid-year budget exercise and go, we just don't know. The money just vanished, right? Is essentially what you're saying. And so Susan Harlowesco Larson, was in charge of the National Food Distribution Task Force under Minnis. And the former prime minister had said that all the records are there. And she said that, hey, we have records and we were good stewards of the money. And there we go. So the Food Distribution Task Force was funded through a couple of means. I don't know exactly which what amount of funds came from which facility, but there was a World Bank loan that we got. It was an emergency World Bank loan to deal with the COVID-19 pandemic, and that was for $100 million. And that was extraordinary because we have graduated from World Bank loan status a long, long time ago, but they let us access that money on an emergency basis for fighting the COVID-19 pandemic specifically. So part of that money went to the Food Distribution Task Force. How much of it, I still don't know. It's still unclear to me. And then there was another extraordinary loan, which was we decided to access $250 million that was made available to us in special drawing rights from the International Monetary Fund. And a great deal of that money went to fighting COVID-19 in different forms. How much all of it went to where, I'm still not 100% sure. The Auditor General produced a report explaining what he could discern from what he couldn't. He said that we didn't know the beneficial owners of the companies that got money for the Food Distribution Task Force, but under nobody was under any illusion from the Auditor General's report that there were no records of where the money actually went, in terms of no one knows what happened to $50 million of the money. In addition to that, when asked in an Office of the Prime Minister press conference about the National Food Distribution Task Force investigation that we were told was ongoing, he said he didn't have anything to add. However, prior to that, Director of Communications at the Office of the Prime Minister, Latre Ramming, told us that it appears $9 million went to a non-NGO for the Food Distribution Task Force. And my thing is this. Which is it? Do you know where the money went, or don't you? Because he's saying one thing. The Auditor General is producing a report that shows where quite a bit of the spending went. The World Bank loan, we asked the Minister of Social Services about it a few days ago. And he says the government's not been able to provide information on where the money from the World Bank loan went because it doesn't have it. He said they wanted to know about the distribution and the exact number of single mothers. They wanted to know the number of children involved. They wanted to know those kinds of details because it helps in further consideration of anything they want to do. Okay? He said it gives you a tracking opportunity to determine the level to which we have problems in our country. So I don't understand, and I spoke about this when we published it, and I don't understand what he's talking about either. All right? Because somebody's got to explain to me what it is that they're talking about. Do you know where the money went, or don't you? Because you said this a few days ago, but last year, you confirmed to us that you had taken over the work of the Food Distribution Task Force, which would have been impossible, as far as I'm aware, if you did not know who they were distributing food to, if you did not know who they were buying food from. So here's what you said in September 30th, all right? The government changed in September 16th, 17th, if you want to be generous. And here's what you said on September 29th. You said, insofar as the food program is concerned, it comes to an end, and then we have to absorb the individuals. He says, I just don't understand why we were spending $800,000 plus per week. I have a difficulty with that. And they buy through a second hand, while it would make more sense to have warehouses of food and calls for the distributions. We can buy it from manufacturers or producers at the factories. Why are we spending an incredible amount of money going through second and third parties when it's costing the state so much and still not getting as many people the food as I'd like them to have? So if you had no information to give to the World Bank, how do you know how much money is being spent on the food? How do you know who they're buying the food from? And how do you know that it's still not getting as many people food as I'd like them to have? How do you know how many people there are getting food? Okay? So when we asked you, because Susan Larson had said that they were assisting 57,000 households when it was first launched, and as of the week of September 30th, they were assisting 17,000 households, you told us, in response to asking about that, that you believe there are much more people who are actually suffering. But how do you know how many people are suffering just in that program in the first place if you have no information to give to the World Bank? He said, we have to find a better way to do it, so we're going to work on that immediately. The program ends now, so we have to move with haste to introduce the new program. Okay? you are telling us that you got the information about the old food program, and you believe it wasn't robust enough, you believe we were spending too much money, you believe that there are more people who should actually be benefiting from the food program, you believe that we're not buying from the right people, but yet you claim earlier this week that you have no information to give to the World Bank. All right, so that was September 30th. When you spoke to the press on October 6th, I believe, of 2021, you told, this is according to Eyewitness News, all right? Actually, you said this at Cabinet, so you told everybody this. You told the press corps that 4,000 people previously on the recently shuttered National Food Distribution Program will be absorbed by the Ministry of Social Services Social Assistance Program. He said, we inherited about 4,000, I'm being told, but I expect that number to change. He noted that that number will be added to those individuals currently on social assistance at the ministry, adding that a systemic program will ensure nobody will be left out. All right, this is Sloan Smith reporting for Eyewitness News. All right, and we asked about the return of the social services debit cards. You said that's going to happen soon. When we asked Clint Watson about that today, he said he doesn't have any information on that, and that's hopefully going to happen soon. So from October to March wasn't soon. And from March to whenever, we don't know when that's going to be. Well, let's just say it's April. Okay? So I got to ask. You say, he said at the time, October, it was a large amount of money spending, and I believe that more people could be satisfied with that amount of money. He said, I think whatever they did at the time was not, in my view, fully discussed to the extent that we were delivering what the Bahamian people really required. And did you have to spend that much, or could you consider another approach? There's a spelling error in this story, Sloan. You might want to go back through it. Wilskum added, in moments of desperation, in the moments of trying to find a plan, they came up with that plan. Okay, so you understood the plan, and you understood how many people were on it. You told the press corps that you inherited 4,000 people from that. And now you tell us you don't have any information to give to the World Bank about it. All right? The information is just not there. You're suggesting that there are no records, which to me, I explained before when the Prime Minister said stuff about the Food Distribution Task Force, and when you said it, that doesn't add up to me. All right. None of this adds up to me. So all that in a vacuum, all right, so the Auditor General is not disclosing what happened. The Auditor General had an IDB report talking about what was spent on food, but said they needed to know, well, part of it talked about food, and said they needed to know beneficial ownership. That's fine. The Director of Communications at the Office of the Prime Minister calls a press conference to summon the press corps to the Office of the Prime Minister to say that $9 million was directed toward an organization that was not an NGO. Then the Prime Minister comes to Parliament, says that there were no real records being kept. And now this Minister of Social Services says that they have no information to provide to the World Bank, which to me is a dangerous thing to say. All right? Straight up. That puts into question the entire government. So you don't say, oh, the World Bank called us and we don't have any information. And then you go tell the world that. Yeah, the World Bank called us and we don't have any information. All right, so we borrow from the World Bank for the first time in forever. And we don't have information to give them. We borrow money from the IMF, all right, Special Drawing Rights Facility. And we're now saying that there are no records to show where this money went. This sort of talk to me is reckless. All right, I get that you're trying to make a point and you have questions about the food program, I got questions too. Many questions. But to suggest that nobody kept any records of how the money was spent and where the money went is an indictment, not on the PLP or the FNM. It's an indictment on the government of the Bahamas. Straight up, a very serious indictment indeed. To say that social services don't have any records, all right? Is an indictment on the entire Department and Ministry of Social Services and an indictment on the government of the Bahamas itself, all right? So these things I don't take lightly because, and I'm not saying this is the extent of why you're doing this. If you're just doing this for people to call talk shows and be like, yeah, there's corruption going on in the food program and all that stuff, that's one thing. But to me, we're playing a dangerous game because this impacts credit. It could impact credit ratings. It could impact our ability to borrow, our ability to remain compliant with international obligations. And to just cavalierly come out and say you don't know, to me, is dangerous. And Obi Wilscombe, I don't even know what you're talking about, man. All right? As you know, I've had my doubts about you for quite some time based on my previous utterances. And my doubts are still there. How you talk about you've absorbed X amount of thousands of people from the program and then come back and say there's no records on the program to give the World Bank is wild. All right? That's not responsible at all. If you have data about the food program, if you have a complete investigation and an audit, then table it in Parliament, release it to the public, whoever needs to get involved, whatever you're talking about, forensic audit, whatever, then do that. But this piece of the story here, piece of the story there, we don't know, we might not know what if Susan Larson kept 9% of $53 million or whatever. Come on. All right? It's just not good enough. So in any event, Susan Larson, and I'll be honest with you, I think that the Holowescos make a convenient target. All right? Do I have questions about the Holowescos' level of involvement in the previous administration? Absolutely. I had questions about Susan Larson, but she seemed to have had it together from what I could see over the course of the Food Distribution Task Force run. But I think the Holowescos are a convenient target to direct a lot of questions and anger and attention toward so that people start looking at them. Now, I wasn't there. I don't know what happened. I don't know who did what. I have major questions about why an NGO would have $2 million sitting on an account that was supposed to go to spend people's money. I want to know, absolutely. But it's got to add up for me. It's got to make sense. It's got to all line up. And I can't, and when you start giving me a piece of the story and you say one thing one day and come back a couple of months later and say another thing, I'm not going to do these mental gymnastics to where I try to connect the dots that you've made no effort to help me with. All right, so I'm not going to sit here and go, oh, this must be the case because I don't know what you're talking about. One of you's telling me you don't know where the money went. One of you's telling me $9 million went to a non-NGO. One of you's telling me you got 4,000 people from the food program that the money's being transferred over. The same person's telling me we were spending $800,000 a week. How do you know that? You know where we were buying it from. And now you're telling me you have no information to give to the World Bank. So, again, we should stop playing Dollyhouse, right? Or what's more current? We should stop playing Barbie Dreamhouse, right? And acting like we're just sitting around the dining room table chopping it up. You're speaking about obligations to international organizations that the Bahamian people owe hundreds of millions of dollars to that we have to fund. And so if you want me to be comfortable that you're a good steward of our money, you have to do better than this. Now, was I comfortable if Minnis was a good steward of our money? No, of course not. But Minnis is gone now. Well, he's still in Parliament. which I was looking at him yesterday and I was like, you got to be a couple sandwiches short of a picnic, right, to have just been prime minister, or I'd like to understand his reasoning. Kind of, he don't got to talk to me. I don't really want to talk to him. I wasn't going to sit there and just take abuse, like, on what, you know what I mean? I was just going to go along my way. That's it. Or even if I didn't resign my seat, which, you know, if I have my wish, he would have. I was gonna rarely come to the house. What is it? You can come like what? Every 60 days before you get vacated? Something like that. I was just gonna show up for roll call and leave. And try to just represent my constituency as best as possible. All right, so yesterday, Candy Adams, who's the executive editor of the Nassau Guardian, she spoke to Susan Larson. She got some comments from her. And she also got quite a bit of information that she says the Ministry of Finance and the Ministry of Social Services has. So she produced the information for us, but all the efforts of the current administration over the past 7 months almost couldn't uncover this information, but we have it. So this story says, it's in the Tribune too, so she didn't just call us. Food program records extensive. Are they? Because Wilscombe said they don't have any. Records raise questions of what Parliament was told. And when I tell you, like, side-eye people, it ain't on air, you know. It ain't because I'd be like, well, I don't like how this dude cuts his mustache. It's because you keep running on with these statements that don't add up. All right? And only so long you could tell me something that don't add up, I can just give you the benefit of the doubt. And we passed that place at least two administrations ago. It says a comprehensive volume of records related to the National Food Distribution Task Force provides deep insight into how the program functioned, how money was distributed to the various NGOs involved, and a meticulous breakdown of the 54,000 households that were assisted. Initially intended to be a 12-week initiative, the food program was in operation for 70 weeks with $53 million in funding and assisted the most vulnerable households during the COVID-19 pandemic when thousands of Bahamians were out of work. The Nassau Guardian yesterday viewed task force records that appear to be in conflict with the government's claim that there were no records on spending, no breakdown on who's being helped, and no paper trail to explain how the program was being managed. The records reflect weekly dashboards from each non-government organization that was a part of the task force. Those dashboards show the income and expenditure of those organizations and an itemized breakdown of how their money was spent, including the number of voucher and food parcels distributed each week. Over the course of the program, 474,420 vouchers and 972,191 food parcels were distributed according to the records of the NGOs involved, not including the Red Cross, which was involved in the task force during its initial stage. The records also showed the weekly disbursement requests made by the task force to the Department of Social Services. In addition, this newspaper had cited a report the task force prepared for the World Bank last year detailing key aspects of the program. The World Bank report and the general records of the task force call into question a claim made by Minister of Social Services Obi Wilscombe on Monday that the government has, quote, been unable to provide the data that they, the World Bank, have been asking for. Wilscombe said they wanted to know about the distribution and the exact numbers to single mothers. They wanted to know the number of children involved. They wanted to know those kinds of details because it helps in further consideration of anything they want to do for the Bahamas. However, a review of the task force database suggests all of those questions could be easily answered as analytics could easily be run on the database. But the minister suggested the task force was not accountable and said he was embarrassed that he could not answer the World Bank, who's asking questions relative to the money spent and asking for the data, and we have none to provide. He said, I think our country should not place itself in that position. So let me, again, I'll stick a pin. This isn't the article. This is just me, right? If you want to find something to attack me for, you know, because I commissioned the bloody food program and all the money responsible, and I'm the one out here talking about we don't have nothing to provide to the World Bank. You can't come out and say we don't have no information to provide to the World Bank and talk about we embarrassed. Okay? That's an emergency. All right? That's not something to be embarrassed about. That is something where your belly should drop. Yo, we borrowed this money in an extraordinary circumstance on behalf of the Bahamian people. When I say we, it's we. Okay? The parliament approved this borrowing. You weren't there, but your party was certainly in parliament. All right? We, the government of Bahamas, borrowed this money on behalf of the Bahamian people, and you feel comfortable talking about you're embarrassed? You can't explain where the money went? You should be afraid to come say this in public. You should have a deep-seated fear about your credibility, about the financial stability and operation of the government of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, and the Bahamian people's confidence that you're actually going to Parliament to borrow money and somehow keeping track of how the money was spent. Because it's the craziest thing in the world to me to come say the government doesn't know where the money went. That it's absurd. Let me just do this and then we'll take a break. It says, the interim, this is back to the article, says in May 2021, the World Bank approved the $100 million COVID-19 response and recovery development policy loan for the Bahamas to support the country's efforts to provide pandemic relief and lay the foundation for resilient economic recovery. The interim funding report was completed by the task force last January for the World Bank. It provides a breakdown of the program's operations. For instance, the report shows that in June 2020, one NGO was overseeing assistance to 2,309 households, 9,943 people, including 4,900 children. 25% of those households had no running water or electricity, and 24% were single-parent households. By the end of 2020, when the first phase of the program ended, the number of households in that zone ballooned from 2,309 to 13,750. Susan Larson, who chaired the task force, confirmed yesterday that the report was turned over to the Ministry of Finance last year to be forwarded to the World Bank. The Nassau Guardian confirmed with a trusted source yesterday that early last year, the Ministry of Finance indeed turned that report over to the World Bank. Larson said the task force also dialogued directly with the World Bank. So you do have information for the World Bank. And in fact, you gave the World Bank information. So exactly what are you talking about, Obi Wolfscombe? When we asked Minister of Economic Affairs, Michael Halkidis, about this yesterday, he said he had no comment. So the Minister of Social Services is telling us that you don't know where the money from the World Bank went. The person who ran the Food Distribution Task Force and someone from within the Ministry of Finance said that the actual report they're talking about was turned over? So what are you talking about? And why you feel so comfortable talking it? We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
One thing there is no debate about is that BTC has the best rates. Now, the best rates just got better because you pay half the price of the other guys with your BTC home internet and mobile services combined. Switching to BTC is a no-brainer because I pay less with BTC and get super fast internet with speeds up to 600 megs. The other guys, their internet only go up to 105 megs.
Get all the internet you want at half the price when you bundle your home internet and mobile. Visit a BTC store to make the switch today. Conditions apply.
From our beginning on Bay Street in 1927, Kelly's House and Home is still going strong. Catch our anniversary sale Friday, April 1st through Wednesday, April 6th. Save 20% off on home decor, housewares, paint, linens, china and gifts, baby, toys, and stationery, except on net items. Come by Saturday, April 2nd, beginning at 7 a.m. and receive a token of our appreciation with purchase while supplies last. Shop online at kellysbahamas.com. Happy 95th anniversary, Kelly's House and Home. We're proud to be a part of your life.
Children are a blessing and should be treated with love and care. They deserve safe, stable, and nurturing relationships, a supportive family environment, and positive social networks. Mothers, fathers, teachers, aunties, uncles, neighbors, Bahamas, let's do our part to stop the physical, sexual, and mental abuse of our children. Make the calls, file the reports, save precious lives. Let's join hands and hearts and say no more to child abuse. This message was brought to you by CFAL, growing wealth for future generations.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
You do coffee your way.
Double shot, decaf, cappuccino.
Light roast, Colombian, no milk.
You do vacations your way.
Hiking boots, tent, mountains.
Five-star hotels and theater.
And now you can do insurance your way.
Online.
Email.
Chat.
WhatsApp.
Or in branch. For home, car, travel, boat, or business insurance, do it anyway with NUA Insurance agents and brokers. Visit NUAinsurance.com, call, or stop by a branch today.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
We know how important collecting your money can be to the success of your business. Start your relationship with Fidelity today so that we can show you the many options available to you with our merchant services. From click and pay options online to merchant terminals and e-commerce options, we're here to help your business succeed. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit any of our branches.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
It's Philly cheesesteak time at Burger King Nassau. This classic sandwich isn't just a Philly cheesesteak, it's a Burger King Philly cheesesteak. Enjoy your sandwich with flame-grilled beef, plant-based, or try the crispy chicken version with all the Philly fixins, including lots of melted cheese, caramelized onions, bell peppers, and mushrooms on a sesame seed hoagie bun. Visit any of Burger King Nassau's 7 locations and enjoy your Philly cheesesteak as a combo or as part of the King's Feast at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
Samantha's always on point. She doesn't miss a thing. When she signs up for any insurance policy, she reads all the fine print. She knows what's covered, what's not covered, and she's aware of her deductibles. When it comes to insurance, it pays to know your policy. Review every insurance policy so you know what you're covered for. This message was brought to you by the Insurance Commission of the Bahamas.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to The Revolutionary. We're talking about the Food Distribution Task Force. At least we got a couple of texts. Oh, this person says, Clint called you guys out for aiding and abetting this NGO. The information you guys printed was not the right info. No, I heard... Hey, let me... This is what I heard, right? And this is when you could tell, like, people are kind of, like, not sure the spin they want to take on it. So Clint says... He hasn't seen what we've seen, but says maybe that's not the right info that they were looking for that we printed. So which is it? Is it that you haven't seen what we've seen? Or is it that you have seen what we've seen so that you can determine it's not the right info? Like, which one is it? It can't be both. Both things can't be true, right? Like, it can't be that you haven't seen it, and therefore you don't know if it's what you're looking for or not, as well as you haven't seen it, but you know that's not what you claim is missing. It can't both be the same thing, right? Because I know how it is, and I expect it, right? I expect you don't have actual facts or data, right? You support the current administration, you know, and you don't ask for facts or data because you're, you know, a sucker, right? Who just anybody could tell you anything, right? Brave says it must be true, right? Because Brave Davis is your pastor, right? Pastor say the world ending. So, ain't no sense preparing for next hurricane season because pastor say the rapture coming, all right? In May. So don't worry about hurricane season in June. I get it, you know. The PLP is your religion. Philip Davis is the bishop. He says it. I don't need no more explanation. God must have shown it to him. All right? Obi Luscombe is the deacon. Deacon and the pastor say the rapture coming. Ain't no records from the food program. And we go, hey, man, here's records for 54,000 households. Here's the report that they said they sent to the Ministry of Finance, that they sent to the World Bank, that you said doesn't exist. Right? And you know, and you, nobody goes, oh, pastor had an affair. That's the report. Pastor get the girl pregnant. The girl show up with the baby. That ain't pastor baby. She lying. That ain't, right? This is the report that they said they sent to the World Bank. You don't at least want to look at it. You don't want to understand if possibly Wilskum could have been wrong. As much as Obi Wilskum has been wrong before and flam before, this is the time that you believe that the rapture's coming. So don't prepare for hurricane season. Jesus. It says, were these numbers audited or signed off by a licensed CPA? I don't know. Is that a requirement, or is that your personal requirement that you're putting on it? Does the World Bank need that? Does the Auditor General ask that? What are you talking about? That's just something you want to see happen before you believe it's real? Were these numbers submitted to the Ministry of Finance and Social Services? Yes. It says, if yes, where's the paper trail to show the submission? We only have our paper trail that we got from these people that show that they did indeed send it to the Ministry of Finance, and I actually know who they sent it to the Ministry of Finance. When were these reports prepared? I just told you when the reports were prepared. Where's the documented reporting procedure? Where's the contract between Larson and the Bahamas government? Let's see the deliverables and the guidelines. Yeah, we can see all that too. Absolutely, I want to see that too. Now, don't you think the government should provide that since the government brought it up, right? Don't you think since the government is saying that they can't find records on it? So who's the onus on to provide the records? I'm wondering. If not the government, who borrowed the money and distributed the money? But great, I want to see the contract because you know enough to tell me that Larson was being paid $7,000 a month. So you must have some information on what the terms were for her to get paid. You know enough to tell me that Larson said X percent was going to administrative costs. So you should be able to provide me documentation on that. I'm with you. I want to see the documents. You're right. I think the Ministry of Finance should provide these documents. It says, Juan, this is donor money. Donors are sticklers. They want verification of data, not just a pretty report. Okay. So who, they want verification of data. Y'all are confusing me on the vagaries of this thing. So Obi Wilskum says there's no information. He says they have no information to provide to the World Bank. Our contact in the Ministry of Finance said the Ministry of Finance sent the World Bank what they asked for. And in fact, Our next stop is to go ask the World Bank exactly what they have and exactly what they had asked Wilscombe for that he said they don't have. So we're going to go check with the World Bank next. All right? So we checked with the Ministry of Finance. We checked with the Food Distribution Task Force. We're going to go check with the World Bank to see what the World Bank asked of the government of the Bahamas and what the government of the Bahamas that borrowed money on our behalf gave to the World Bank. You're right. There's still stuff missing. Absolutely. World Bank's my next stop. That's who I want to talk to next. All right. Says, hey, Juan, what's going on here? This is the first time in history I noticed Guardian Radio is going an extra mile to prove what that lady is saying is the truth and trying to undermine what the minister said. Firstly, and I want to be as pellucidly clear as possible, I don't take what Obi Wilscombe says at face value. Not for the past, decade. You might, and he may feel some type of way about me saying that, but that's what it is. All right? We've asked Obi Wilscombe about the Caribbean Music Festival on numerous occasions. He now sits in the same cabinet as Alfred Sears, who was suing the government over the Caribbean Music Festival, where nobody could account to me where $600,000 that was supposed to be spent on a festival that never happened went. We've asked him numerous times about numerous issues in government, and he almost never provides a clear answer. So forgive me if all my experience with certain people functioning in government leads me to question the public statements they make. Again, you can believe that pastor spoke to God and the rapture's not happening, so don't buy, the rapture's gonna happen, so don't buy hurricane supplies. Not me. And that you don't feel good about that, that you feel like sudgy about that. Remember that? Sudgeon? That you're sudgeon over that? That I'm actually going to the head of the Food Distribution Task Force and asking them what they have when Wilscombe says he has nothing? That's just gonna have to be on you. I'm always gonna go double check what everyone says, especially him. We'll be right back.
Wait, you know what's going down tomorrow?
Nobody, what happening?
Joe bringing the knife to school? He could do Junior in?
For what?
Wait, he fooled with Joe girl?
Mother sick. And you know Junior don't bark down for nothing. So that means you got a big fight tomorrow.
So whose side you on?
Side? I trying to stay in school, not Simpson fan. You gotta tell somebody about this fight.
Tell somebody? I ain't no snitch. I mean cool, you know.
Wait, if you so cool, then you need to stay in school and stay out of the fight.
Yeah, but if I don't hang on Joe's side, him and he boys coming for me next.
All right, so we definitely gotta tell somebody. We gotta prevent the fight.
What I say, I don't want nobody call me snitch.
We could just call Crime Stoppers. You could report what you know, and nobody gotta know it's you.
So how do I work?
All you gotta do is call them, or you text them through the Crack Crime Bahamas app, and nobody can know it's you.
Then the police come looking for me for more info, and when they finish with them, Joe them coming looking for me?
When you call Crime Stoppers, the calls go directly to Miami, and they don't ask nothing about you. Then you can get the pin from them, and they can claim a reward later using that same pin.
Plus, everything's scrambled, so nobody can read what you said.
Calls 328-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
You do coffee your way.
Double shot decaf cappuccino.
Light roast, Colombian, no milk.
You do vacations your way.
Hiking boots, tent, mountains.
Five-star hotels and theater.
And now you can do insurance your way.
Online.
Email.
Chat.
WhatsApp.
Or in branch. For home, car, travel, boat, or business insurance, do it anyway with NUA Insurance agents and brokers. Visit NUAinsurance.com, call, or stop by a branch today.
Know how important collecting your money can be to the success of your business. Start your relationship with Fidelity today so that we can show you the many options available to you with our merchant services. From click and pay options online to merchant terminals and e-commerce options, we're here to help your business succeed. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit any of our branches.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and the generator's back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them at 242-356-0249.
Happy anniversary, My Gateway. Did you know that you can request and pay for over 35 government services on mygateway.gov.bs? Sign up today and access government services online with efficiency and simplicity. It's a celebration of a year of collective success on our digital transformation journey. My Gateway, making government work for you.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. My name is Juan McCartney. So good to have you with us. We are talking about the Food Distribution Task Force. The data given to us by Susan Larson, who is the head of the Food Distribution Task Force, and trying to line up what she has against what Wilshkam has said and what the Prime Minister has said. Now, I see a lot of people, I see some people go, oh, is this a CPA approved? Did somebody sign off on it? Did somebody previously say that that's what they required? Did the Prime Minister say we have data, just a CPA didn't look at it, and therefore, because a CPA didn't have it, it doesn't exist? Did the Minister of Social Services say that, that they produced reports that weren't audited to our satisfaction and therefore we don't have any information? And is it in the realm of possibility that Susan Larson would have just sat down and banged out information on 54,000 different households and 970,000 vouchers sometime after the Prime Minister spoke about it? Sure, anything's possible. Is that likely? I'm not so sure. All right. Here's what I learned. And you're not going to look at it the same way as I do. And I still have this habit where I don't remain open, right? So my issue is, you could say anything to me. That doesn't mean I'm going to believe it, but I don't discount it, all right? And sometimes I still do, and I shouldn't. But anything's possible, all right? And the financial secretary, Simon Wilson, he said that not having information on the food distribution task force could negatively impact the Bahamas' international credit rating and ability to secure loans. And I completely agree with him. Completely. All right? That level of information is needed to make sure that your sovereign credit rating, well, it's double junk anyway, but still, right? We still have the ability to borrow. All right. Now, these guys are saying that they don't have that information. All right. We got the information from a woman. Did she make it all up? Hey, anything's possible. Anything's possible, right? Is that what y'all want me to go on? Because, like, Wilscombe's pure as the driven snow. And he don't make stuff up? Because but I get it. You want to be comfortable in your political belief. I don't do that. I don't get comfortable, right? I don't get comfortable. People get disappointed. Oh, McCartney, I thought you were right here with me on this. I don't get comfortable. I'm right where the information is, all right? In the absence of information, I'm waiting, right? Someone says, don't suggest Wilscombe make stuff up. I mean, that's not to libel him or defame him. I just, past experiences with stories that we've covered with him leads me to believe that we must verify the information as we should as responsible journalists and verify what we are being told. We must verify what we are being told. He said that there is no information to give to the World Bank. Simon Wilson appears to be suggesting the exact same thing. I find this all very curious. But we'll talk about what Susan Larson has. I'm going to say it for you again. Caribbean Music Festival. All right? Go look up the Caribbean Music Festival. It's not a ton of money. It's a ton of money to me. I don't have 600 grand. It's not a ton of money compared to $53 million. But just look at that. And try to get a straight answer. I've dealt with so many people on so many things, and you try to get a straight answer, you can't. And I must believe you being straight with me, just because of you, just because you're looking me in the eye. I don't hurt at all, player. I don't just believe what you say. I don't just believe what no politician say. Sorry, let me rephrase that. I don't believe what nobody says. Nobody, until I can verify it. Because you don't know. My wife told me the other day she was going to go see her sister. I don't know where she was. You got to have faith. You know what I mean? And I'm willing to have that in my marriage. But not with y'all who have carriage over my money. It ain't no faith-based relationship we in. We got trust. But verification is a critical part of it. So no, you can't just tell me you don't have no information and somebody else tell me they have information. I go, well, this person must have made it all and they must be lying. Look, explain to me what this woman is talking about. And I'm going to go check with the World Bank. And then we could all sit around the table and talk. But until then, just believe what you say. No, that's not going to happen. For y'all. Okay. Y'all do that if y'all want to believe. If y'all that money. My brother, listen to me. I went to the food store yesterday, right? And I'm not going to call no names. The food bill for the same amount and types of food appears to be rising by at least 15% every 2 weeks. And on that, you're the collecting VAT. So you think I'm going to be here on Guardian Radio because you like the PLP or you like the FNM? I'm just going to be here and swallow whole whatever anyone tells me. I pay VAT too, player. All right? I pay taxes too. If you don't care about what happens to your tax dollars because you have this belief that the politicians always tell you what's really going on, then go ahead and let your money burn. It ain't going to happen to me. And it ain't no disparaging remark you could say to me. It ain't nothing you could say what somebody else said about me that's going to make me stop doing it. So if you can't handle it, you should check out. Because this is my level. All right? This is where I am. If you can't get there with me, I fully understand. But I don't just believe nothing nobody say. Period. That magical thinking about politics and all that stuff, I'm not a participant. You're on your own with it. Didn't we have an interview book today? No? All right. Always tomorrow. Well, we got Simeon Hall Jr. Chef Simeon Hall Jr. is coming back tomorrow. All right. He's in South Carolina, I believe. He's come back tomorrow and he's going to do a giveaway. He's got a giveaway to one of his cooking lessons. I forget the name he told me. All right, let's continue with the story. Y'all told me. Y'all have nothing. All right. Am I mistaken? Let me double check. Okay. So Obi Wilskum said we have nothing, and he's embarrassed. And remember I said, okay, him saying he's embarrassed is strange to me because Simon Wilson is correctly saying it, and it goes beyond embarrassment. This could impact our credit rating. Our ability to borrow. The World Bank isn't going to give you any more money if you tell them you don't know what happened to the money they just gave you. Oh, we got calls? Sure, let's do calls. No problem. Let's do it. I can't do it for you, man. I can't tote no PLP line for you. I can't tote no FNM line for you. It's not me a ton of fair weather friends, but it just is what it is. I gotta go live with myself after this. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Good afternoon, my brother Juan. How you doing?
I'm good. How's it going?
Good show, man. You know, I'm training you right now. It's hard. It's hard to be number one. You're doing an excellent job. See, a lot of people don't know the means of the 46. You know, and I put a little pressure on you to write them. Now you bring my boy Naughty on at 46. You're doing your job. That's your job. You see, and I like what you're saying. I'd be saying the same thing. Hey, I got 3 or 4 chat groups, and I am the only administrator. See, what I want you to do after to make my 5 cents, play the scream up with Santa Mother Pratt, please. I think I'm the one who got that right there. Play the scream of the center mother who has told you, see, I believe God wicked and mysterious with the brave David that we're doing. All he's trying to tell this cabinet minister and all the people, you mess around, you're going to jail. God wicked. See, the food is, right, and I tell people every day, people like me is willing to pay tax. The government makes plenty of money for me, man. They make plenty of money for me. You see? And we need to fix this country. You see, and I don't understand why people come and tell a bunch of nonsense and they don't do the research. And Obi is my boy. He's my football friend, boy. You don't talk phone, man. People be listening. They got this phone to talk sense. And we have a lot of people that listen to the voice of these lying politicians. They want him to say it. All politicians are lying. Most of them
I ain't calling him no liar. I
can call him liar.
Verification.
But I can call him liar. I don't worship man. I don't blind nose. I speak the truth. When I was talking about that airspace for the past 20, 25 years, one lady called to say, "Do you know what JJ said?" And let us on a man, I said, for 10 years. Now we getting dividends. We get dividends. Many people call the talk show talking, hey, election all. Make me the great deal. You are going to govern now. Juan, you won't get slapped for 6 months?
The what?
You won't get slapped for 6 months?
Me? I don't want to get slapped at all.
No, I just saying it because they said, oh, only 6 months. 5, 6 months, many times to govern. Fix it and go and govern for all that you are saying. Collect the money from the Bank Bahamas, $500 million. Collect the money. Let them pay. I'm trying to take my call, my brother.
All right, no problem. Okay, so anyway, Larson said the reports were sent to the World Bank, and we're not calling anybody a liar, all right? But Larson said the reports were sent to the World Bank. Wilskum says there's no information. I'm going to go find out what the World Bank says. That's who I want to talk to. I'm going to talk to the World Bank. Because I'd love to know what information they have or is outstanding. Since we brought it all up. So Halkidis, he didn't explain or back anything that Wilskum said. He offered no comment. We have to figure out exactly what we're talking about. All right. So I'm going to call the World Bank. I got the number right here. I'm going to do that after the show. I'm going to call them and email them at their headquarters in Washington, D.C. Let's do that so that we don't gotta run back and forth to the minister, to the food distribution chair, to the office of the prime minister, to the financial secretary. Let's see what the World Bank says. World Bank Country Director for the Caribbean is Tashin Saeed. Yeah, we're going to see what that person has to say today. I'm going to call them today. All right. We can continue with the Food Distribution Task Force, or we can take your calls. There's more information. Candia breaks it down. Let's go to the... By the way, I'll give you a little bit of inside baseball. Because if you think that the editors of The Guardian are all just some hive mind who all are on the same thrust, we're not, right? And so my thought process on this was to raise an alarm when Brave Davis made all these revelations, I guess you want to say. Accusations could also be another word to say. And my thought process was, this is very, very, very serious. And the Food Distribution Task Force and the NGOs need to be able to answer. And I didn't give them the benefit of the doubt. The benefit of the doubt. I still do not give them the benefit of the doubt. All right. And Candia's thinking was different. Candia's thinking was, if I'm phrasing it correctly, her thinking was Davis is making the accusation, all right? It is on the accuser to provide the evidence that wrongdoing occurred. And I said, okay. I said, you know what? And that's interesting because the framing of this all is that there just is no information. So you notice nobody's come out directly and said, anybody stole money, anybody, you know, did something wrong with the money. Most people have come out and say, we just don't know. right? And so there's this specter of, well, if you don't know. So our thinking was in the exact same on this. My thinking was, hey, Davis is making some very serious accusations about these people who got a lot of money. They need to answer what's going on. And her thinking was kind of like, well, Davis is making the accusation, so Davis should, you know, make sure that he has proof to back up what he's saying. And so we settle on, you know, hey, we'll investigate, we'll report what it is. You guys, I don't know, some of you out there, like your head's so far, like up someone, you know, up somewhere, that you don't consider that people actually think rationally, and this country has people like that. You think everyone's just paid off because you're bought and sold so easily, right? So you think everyone, yeah? You don't make your bed in the morning, so nobody makes their bed in the morning, that kind of way. Like, you have no convictions, so nobody has convictions. You don't think through things, so nobody else thinks through things, right? But my initial reaction was, this is very serious, we need to look at it. And I still hold that view. And, you know, Wilskum made an accusation that there was no information. And Davis made accusations. And now someone's providing information. We have a duty to look at it. And I'm going to go call the World Bank and the IMF while I'm at it to go figure out where we are with this. We got a phone call? Sure. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Good afternoon. Are you there? No, not there. I took too long. My bad. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Hey, Vaughn.
Hey, what's happening, my brother?
Hey, all is well.
Good.
Tell me something, man. When it comes to distribution of food or any parcel of besides private organizations, isn't social service supposed to be the number one distributor when it comes to dealing with food and different things, especially when it comes to disasters or like how we find ourselves a couple years ago in this real COVID situation?
Yeah, usually, yeah. Mm-hmm.
The reason why I ask that is that, do you realize that social service ain't got much to say about this?
Well, the minister are talking.
No, I mean, I'm not talking about the minister. I'm talking about those who were, you know, were still at social service then. The simple fact is, as I understand it, that social service wasn't really really a part of
this. They appear to have been circumvented. Yeah.
Right, and I'm trying to figure out and ask yourself that question, Mr. McCartney. Why is it that our real feeding program or outreach program to those who are in need or those who are in times of crisis, why is it that social service was not involved?
Yeah.
You know, and Mr. McCartney, I listened to Dwight's show this morning. I just listened to it, and I listened to people saying that the PLP, they're waiting on the PLP callers to call to see if they can water this down because now that Ms. Lawson or whoever come up with this story, right? But I want Bahamian people to know that this is still an ongoing thing. The Prime Minister or the Minister of Finance has not come back and say, well, if they're wrong or they're right. Remember that now. I want Bahamian people to understand that. The only thing that's coming out is findings. Findings is something that you have to go through in order if it warrants an investigation. And Bahamian people need to understand that. So the PLP or Mr. Davis or the government didn't get an egg in their face, people.
No, I wouldn't say that, because nobody came direct. Well, the Prime Minister didn't come directly out and say anybody did anything wrong, right? He just said that they're looking into it, and it's very interesting. He said there's been a lack of information and record keeping, et cetera. So we're looking at, as far as Wilskum talking about, they have nothing. I got to question him saying that. That's a serious thing to say.
That's true. When I say true, I mean, and he speaks his mind. But at the end of the day, now let's be realistic now, Mr. McCarthy. Let's just wait and see what the ending results of this can be. But between me and you, I can say this to you and to those who are listening. It ain't going to be good for some people, but you have a good day, my brother.
No problem. And hey, you know what it is? The chips fall where they may. I know y'all think I have a problem with Wilskum. It ain't that. He may think I have a problem with him. It is what it is, right? Listen to me. You're speaking to a man who covered every single day of the Pleasant Bridgewater, Torino Lightbourne trial. Okay, so you ain't gotta look at what Juan say. There's a court record that shows you everybody fied, all that went down, all right? You don't gotta just... So go read the transcript of the Pleasant Bridgewater, the Reno Lightbourne trial, then come back to me and tell me exactly whose word I should trust on air. Please. Go do that for me. All right, and you'll help to understand where my head's at. Yeah, this is the PM also said people in the former administration sought to enrich themselves and use public office as an extractive industry. The two examples he then gave were the food program and the beaches and park. Yeah, that's true. He did it. He did say people in the former administration were dealing in darkness. He did say that. He ain't called no names. It says, see how Dwight changes talk when it was Minnis did not wait. I don't even know what that means. I don't know what Dwight does. It says, Juan, you can say what you want, but the truth is the PL King Minnis looked good. Minnis was really telling the truth about this food assistance. Wow. Well, again, I don't know who's telling the truth and who's not. Minnis said all the records are there. Minnis, you can... you can think that Minnis did a good thing with the food program, as well as think Minnis wasn't a good prime minister. Those two things can exist in the same space. And DeWitt asked why was social services not the main thing involved with the food program. I can understand it, because social services move slowly. No diss to all social services. It just go ask the average Bahamian who goes applies for social assistance, right? And it was exigent that they provide food to people. And when this first occurred... And I got in problems for it. I won't say too much about it, but when this first occurred, I was very skeptical of the program and why it was being done, how it was being headed up and everything like that. And I saw that it was an actual real thing. Did it work the way everyone said it should work? I don't know. But I was skeptical as well. All right. There's one, I listen to only two shows, yours and Dwight's, but you have it hands down because you don't pacify, smooth over, try to make nice. When you throw your rock in the crowd, the dog that cries is the perpetrator. I mean, I can't help you. If you want, like, to feel good about the PLP and the F, I can't do that for you. We're just looking at what we're being told, because this is money that's borrowed on our behalf that we got to account for. So when you tell me you don't have no accounting for the money, I don't just go, well, damn, what were Minnis them doing? I go, well, no, I got an issue with the entire government now. You're telling me no one in government can explain what's going on with where our money went, and nobody called the cops, nobody called the, all right, nobody. Says, Juan, help me as a Bahamian because I lost. How's it that the minister says he don't have no data, but the woman shows she sent everything in, and now y'all have it? The government is playing dangerous politics. They're prepared to damage the country's name image because they don't like the FNM or Holowesco. You know, I don't know what it is. And some people have said to me, well, it's an issue with the Holowescos and the PLP. And maybe that's so, right? My thing is this. You guys, you won the election. All right, you're in charge of government. You have every mechanism to figure out what's going on fully and to hold people to account. It says, he who accuses must prove. I agree with that as well. This says, the misstatement about the World Bank records is consistent with the behavior of this government. The Minister of Health made similar specious statements when he got to office. These politicians appear caught up in shaming rather than governance. Let's focus. Where's the plan to right the economy? We are in too precarious a position as a country for this nonsense. It's as if this was the first rodeo for these people. This is troubling to the extreme. Well, we're going to see what the World Bank has to say. It says, Taiwan is a tree. You don't need a COVID test to move around the islands of the Bahamas. Not anymore, no. It says, Juan, some of our leaders have not been to school with white people, so they think their peers are driven snow. I'm black, who's been to school with white people, live in a condo with white people. Some of them are not the bastion of honesty.
What?
Juan, how do you think the white people have all the land and money in this country? Most of their forefathers were born poor. Now, like, they are like Russian oligarchs. Okay, fair enough. The white people are the Russian oligarchs. I gotcha. Thank you for your investigative journalism skills. For too long, these politicians in the Bahamas have been misrepresenting the facts about innocent, decent Bahamians, all for political mileage. God will expose them all. I have a friend who was destroyed by a political witch hunt. It needs to stop. Look, and you can't, and these things don't become a defense of what I'm doing, because that's what happens. People go on you. Remember your boy, Anton, who got banned? That's what he was doing with BPL. Without stopping to consider what he was being told about BPL, he just launches into this trying to get at me, right? Because you people foolishly believe if you attempt to discredit the person who's saying it, that it makes it somehow not true what they're saying. So again, and if, I'm sorry you got banned, Anton, but you know, if you're over your feelings, you can call back after Easter, I think, right? I wrote report after report after report on what was going on at BPL. Okay? The chairperson of BPL is related to me. The former chairperson of BPL is related to me. All right? And that still did not stop me from questioning what the PLP is doing with BPL. Because I just want to know, because it's our money. It's what we're doing. All right? And that's just how it is. This says, I sat in a meeting where a report was presented to an international organization. We did 10 of this, 15 of that, 30 of the other. You know, the first question that was asked, where did this data come from? How do we verify it? Yeah, true. I agree. You got to be able to verify, no doubt. Says, one, all financial transactions should be certified, whether provided by government or private concerns at all times. Yeah, you should be able to prove that it actually happened, sure. This is great show as usual, Juan. Your analogy with your wife is going to cause...
No.
She's going to say, so you don't believe I be where I say I be? No, I do believe. That's my thing. I have faith. But I don't know. Right? And I'm willing to do that with certain relationships. Right? I'm willing to extend that trust. I'm not going to check your phone. I'm not going to do like a data location or a locate... find my phone location on you. You weren't by your sister. I don't... you know, I'm not going to do that in my personal relationships with government. We don't have that kind of relationship. All right? I need evidence. I need receipts. So I didn't know Anton was banned. Really? Yeah, until after Easter, he can call back. You know? But what I need him to understand is this isn't a meeting of the wills between he and I, right? This is my show, and you can contribute to what's being said. Beyond that, I'm not interested in you press me down or gain one up on me. It's just not get your own show and go knock yourself out with that. That's not what my show is for. Because last I checked, I didn't spend a dime of government money. Says, Juan, you're right. I hate when people are in the position to have access to information the regular person does not have because they refuse to have a serious Freedom of Information Act. Then they act like the information is somehow being kept from them. So was the minister misleading the public on the feeding program? Mr. Wilson have to address this issue and be truthful with us. Well, we'll see what the World Bank has to say. And we'll see what the IMF has to say about all this. It is, and you could talk to Lang about this, right? And I don't think he'll disagree with me. It is stunning for the Minister of Finance to say no records were kept on $53 million, even if he wasn't in charge, and that no extremely serious action has been taken. It is stunning to me to say that for the Minister of Social Services to come out and say in public, we have no information, even though it contradicts what he previously said, to say we have no information to give to the World Bank when they're checking to see how the loan money was spent. when this was an emergency loan, an extremely serious loan. And in fact, I'm trying to figure out how you qualified for the loan. How do you apply for the loan without that information? That's what I'm thinking. We got a break? Let's take a break. But pick up The Guardian. You can see it all there.
About is that BTC has the best rates. Now, the best rates just got better because you pay half the price of the other guys with your BTC home internet and mobile services combined. It's a no-brainer because I pay less with BTC and get super fast internet with speeds up to 600 megs. The other guys, their internet only go up to 105 megs.
Get all the internet you want at half the price when you bundle your home internet and mobile. Visit a BTC store to make the switch today. Conditions apply.
Let Wendy's heat up your morning. Wake up with our new hot honey chicken biscuit that is forged in flavor and made fresh every morning just for you. Forged from a fusion of sweet honey and spicy heat. Wendy's new hot honey chicken biscuit is our breaded premium all-white chicken breast topped with habanero honey served on a fresh baked buttermilk biscuit. It offers the perfect balance of sweet heat. Better mornings always start at Wendy's.
Do you know you can get your business cards designed and printed for as low as 18 cents a card? If it's a poster you want, you can pay as little as $6 a square foot. If your print needs a short or long run, digital printing, wide format, or print consultation, call the best. Call Printmasters. Printmasters' goal is to provide its clients with the highest level of personal, professional service at an affordable price. Technology also makes working together efficient and easy. Laminations, business cards, flyers, posters, window and floor decals are just a few of the digitized print services offered at Printmasters.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located at the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Here we go.
J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents are the best. Reliable service, we've been on the scene, protecting since 1919.
Loss of family members is very isolating, and people who have experienced loss appreciate when others have shared their grief. If you can't be there in person, go to the Nassau Guardian's website online at thenassauguardian.com and visit our obituary link. The Nassau Guardian's interactive obituary link allows you to read the funeral announcement, express condolences, or an online guestbook for one full year. Losing a loved one is painful, but that pain isn't the worst thing to happen. Friends, loved ones, colleagues, and neighbors who ignore the loss compound the pain. Should the bereaved family wish to place the obituary and photos on our obituary site, just contact the Guardian's funeral industry partners or the Nassau Guardian. Remember, there isn't one magic right thing to say to someone experiencing loss that will make the loss less painful or easier to bear. The Nassau Guardian's obituary link, available online at thenassauguardian.com.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. We're talking about the National Food Distribution Task Force and all the strange things that have come out of it. I'm going to be real with you. Before anything was said about this, I never had any sort of inkling that there was this great controversy surrounding the Food Distribution Task Force. I didn't. Now, if you're asking me about some other stuff like the DRA, other contracts, issues, etc., I would say, yeah, there were some questions there. But I'm not going to lie to you, I never really questioned too hardcore what was going on with the Food Distribution Task Force once it started going up and running, because we covered the organizations giving out the food. We covered people getting the food. Everyone wasn't happy with a lot of food they got. But it was actually happening, right? We know it happened. It wasn't something that we just that was just made up that didn't occur. We went there when they were preparing the packages, when they were delivering the food. We have pictures of the volunteer. Like, I don't know what else, what more is required. Would we have liked to seen receipts for the purchases and everything? Sure. You know? But it ain't like the Food Distribution Task Force didn't happen. Now, I understand you say you're not sure about what all went down, but it certainly did happen. Okay. Says this week an investor that was jumping up and down and was named in a multi-million-dollar fraud investigation opened by the SEC. The filing specifically mentioned how money was funneled to real estate investments in the Bahamas. How this man with all his courses, Commission Immigration, the Economic Council, the Minutes, because that's what data does. It says what you want it to say. And if no one verifies it, they get what they get. I don't know. Is that a reasonable example? That's what data does. It says what you want it to say. Is that what it does? Or does data actually just say what it is? By the way, and I'm going to get in trouble for this, but I think that sometimes you should just kind of like YOLO. I want to say, anyway, I'll ask another question. Does anyone notice how there are often multi-million dollar real estate projects that are on some of the best land available in New Providence that are finished with luxury accommodations that just sit empty? Does anyone else find that strange? And while they sit empty, land adjacent to that project, behind the project, they start building more multi-million dollar real estate projects that also often sit empty. Does anyone find that strange? Just me. I also think there's a serial killer loose in the Bahamas as well. I have no proof of that, but do you notice, like, about over the past year, there's been about 5 or 6 instances where people found bodies, right, that were in weird places that nobody can explain? Did you see about they found the remains of the taxi driver, like in a shallow grave? And they said the taxi driver had gotten a call to the airport, and that's the last anyone's seen him. And now they found his body, like, and you know how they identified his body? He had his wallet on him. I think something's going on. I can't prove it. Maybe I've read too many books and watched too many movies. Something's going on. All right. This says, if Alawesco said she sent the info to the World Bank and the World Bank says they don't have information, then one of those parties is not telling the truth. But the World Bank didn't say anything. All right. This is what Wilscombe said. He has no information to give to the World Bank. The World Bank's looking for information. They have none. That's what he said. This says, Juan, the accountant's out here, not substantivity test. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I can agree with that. We got a lot of text. Says, Juan, you could actually do a location search on someone. That's how my girl will catch me. Thanks, Juan. Good looking out. I was never like that. Right? So, firstly, if you're going to cheat on me, I can't stop you from cheating on me. Unless I lock you up in the house. Right? Secondly, if you are cheating on me, I don't want to know that. That's not going to make me feel better that I know. I'd rather not know. That's my rule, right? Right. Just don't. Right. T-conscious, dude, take it to your grave. You plan on doing it again? No, just take it. I gotta tell her. I feel so guilty. I went to church. Dude, that's between you and Jesus. Yeah? You take it to your grave. Now, if you get caught and confessions have to ensue, then you handle it then. Otherwise, shut up about it. All right? Leave it alone. Take it to your grave. This says, Juan, stop exposing how I clean up money via building projects. You shall receive a white envelope with some substance this evening. Please inhale slowly. Seriously, you don't look at all these places around here that are like luxury places with ocean views, marble floors and all, and nobody's living in them for years, and then people just start building. Like if I were a rich person, right? And I was like, you know what? I got some money to go burn. I want to get some real estate in the Bahamas. I'm going to go buy something that's already built. Why would you build something here? It's hard enough. I got questions. This says, very curious one, that real estate stuff sounds like money laundering. And I need to stop by this serial killer you put in my pressure up. There's about 6 homicides over the past, like, 18 months, I want to say, that nobody can explain. Anyway. Says, I really hope the IDB, IMF, and whoever else never gives us a loan again. We're too wicked and corrupt. Speak for yourself. We wicked and corrupt. I need the loan. I want this IDB money, son. We got roads to build out here. Bridges, airports. How you think these things get built? This is Juan, you should have told that take it to the grave advice to Jada. Yeah, I guess so. Me? You ain't got to worry about that. And I don't want to know. This women do that. Oh, I got to tell him for my conscience. No. You feel guilty by yourself. And just keep your guilt self-contained. I don't need to share in your infidelity. We don't all, that doesn't need to be our thing. That's just your thing. You deal with that by yourself till the day I die, right? It says, Juan, you're trying to spook us at NASA with this serial killer out here. Scary, man. Everyone's a suspect. I don't have any information. I don't have any evidence. I'm just saying I have questions. It says, it's all about the data and how you interpret or misinterpret what you see. Get it wrong or right, and someone gets slapped. So you have good hair and you want better hair, but in the process, you lose the hair you have. Well, I'm just saying. He said there's nothing. She said there's something. We'll see what the people who are asking for it say, if they say anything. Good day. How does one get legal guardianship of a child they had for 7 years and the parents are alive? I tried calling Social Service Supreme Court for information. Boy, I have no earthly idea. Call Narissa Green at Hallsbury Chambers. She deals with a lot of these family legal matters. Narissa Green, tell her I sent you. It says, one, in this country, it appears that you should not question anything or anyone, especially if it's your political party. Do you see why we're in the dilemma we're in a lot of areas? So you investigating this misleading comment is just beyond. I think you're in your rights. Continue on. Taxpaying citizens would love to hear. Well, don't worry about it. So I'm fairly certain that this talk show isn't going to last beyond this administration, because I'll be 50 by the time they come out, and I'll have given you about over 10 years of this, so I'm good. But dude, it won't be this show for certain. I can't do it. It might not last beyond this year, but certainly it won't last beyond this administration. So you won't have me to deal with forever. I'll be alive. Just the revolution probably won't be a thing. It says, Green is no longer at Hosbury Chambers. Oh, really? I didn't know that. She's at Providence Law? Oh, yeah, go check Narissa Green at Providence Law. There you go. So the person who's asking about obtaining guardianship over a child has to go to a justice of the peace to do that. Okay? It says, wait, one, are you saying ignorance is bliss with regard to cheating on me? Yeah. I mean, if everybody know, right, I don't want to be a sucker. You know what I mean? And everybody's like whispering behind my back. If it's just something that happened, what's the movie name? You ever watch The Firm or read the book with Tom Cruise? Excellent. It's a book by John Grisham. Anyway, he's working for a firm. Anyway, I'm not going to talk it for you. Anyway, he goes to an island, right? I think in the book he went to the Bahamas, but it's a different island in the movie. And he's just by himself, his wife's back home, right? And he's just on a beach. And he's drinking. It's beautiful, right? And he has like a one-night stand with her. And he goes back home, and he feels like dirt. And he just keeps it to himself, all right? And somebody was taking pictures of him in order to blackmail him. And so he had to fess up. If it's like that, right, then yeah. If nobody ever knows, right? No pictures, no nothing. I'm not gonna make it a habit. You were indiscreet. I get it. One time. Keep it to yourself. Now you can't have a whole family, and then I know how y'all go in Nassau. Your family two corners down. You got a whole another family. The children look just like you. They pass each other on the way to school. That ain't going. It says, Juan, you have a lot of cookies in the cookie jar. No one knows how or when all the cookies ran out, Juan. We just know there's no more cookies. Oh, wait. They found 3 cookies from the side drawer a few weeks ago. Find the invoices. No wholesaler sends goods out of the drawer without an invoice. Says you lost everyone at the book. Well, say another family. Actually, I'll go. Y'all have 2 families. They used to do this back in like the 70s. Like it was impossible to figure it out. Anyway, we got to go. All right, we got to go. Pick up the Guardian. You can read about the Food Distribution Task Force. I don't have any data that suggests, I don't have any information to concretely say there's a serial killer out here. I'm just saying. It's weird. All right, we'll be back tomorrow, Lord willing, with Chef Simeon Hall Jr. We're going to talk food. You guys have a great day. Take care out there, Bahamas.